好，咁我去到第二個嘅 investment appraisal 嘅方法啦。咁啊，第二個咧，我都相信咧，都係可以話係呢一課最重要嘅一個方法啦。咁我可以話俾大家聽。咁咧，呢個叫做 net present value。咁啊，咁我哋要第一樣啦，咁要記得個名啦。第二咧就要記得咧嗰個嘅definition。咁啊 ，definition 多一次啦。Use discounted cash flow to assess whether the project brings an increase in net worth。咁有兩個字咧，我間低咗嘅。第一個咧就 discounted cash flow。discounted cash flow 咧，要講緊嘅咧，就其實咧佢係牽涉到呢一個 time value of money 嘅，即係話佢會將個 cash future cash flow 咧會將佢做個 discounting。咁咩叫 discounting 咧？咁我哋可以睇翻之前我哋喺compulsory part 講呢一個time value of money 嘅時候嗰條片啦。咁應該是屬於第一課嗰度嘅，咁啊 ，increase in net worth 嘅意思咧，即係話究竟呢個 project 咧會帶俾間公司有幾多新嘅價值啦 ？OK， 得唔得？一個新嘅價值，咁呢個係嗰個嘅重要性。咁當然講翻個 decision rule 啦 ，decision rule 咧基本上就好簡單嗰啲，我哋都 accept 高啲嘅，不過有個嘢好重要就係 positive 嘅 NPV 咧，我哋會 accept negative 嗰啲我哋會 reject 嘅，即係話帶嚟唔到任何盈利嗰啲咧，咁我哋就唔。不做的了，咁呢個話俾你聽咧 ，discount 完之後帶嚟有一個盈利，所以我哋會 accept。咁當然啦，兩個 mutually exclusive 嘅意思咧，即係話如果嗰兩個 project either one choice 嘅話咧，咁我哋會選高啲，而當然要正嗰個啦，係咪？咁啊，個條式咧就係咁啦。咁我哋睇 DSE 嚟講咧，試過咧就係將條式咧去問大家有啲咩嘅 formula elements 嘅。咁 formula elements 咧就包括以下呢四項啦。咁第一個咧就 initial cash outlay， 即係咁你之後第二個就個 discount rate 啦、net cash flow 啦同埋 project life， 咁你話咦咁熟口面嘅呢啲，其實如果大家有印象咧，呢啲我哋其實基本上咧就我哋喺4.1之前講緊嗰啲嘅 financial factor 啦。咁其實我哋所有啲 financial factor 咧嘅源自於咧都喺 NPV 嗰啲 item 入邊去攞出嚟嘅。咁我哋話啦，如果當題目問你 financial factors， 其實你可以比較直接啲嘅角度咧，可以從翻 net present value 入邊考慮嘅 formula 嗰啲 elements， 或者我哋叫 variables， 所以我哋呢啲叫做呢啲全部都係一啲數學上嘅 數學上一啲叫做 variable 嘅嘢啦 ，variable 即係話嗰個變量啊，中文即係叫做 咁啊寫翻好啲啊，咁我叫做。呢一個 NPV 啦，得唔得？咁啊，所以你詳細解我就唔多講啦。咁反而咧，純粹咧想同大家去講一講就係、是，個變量嘅影響咧，對於唔同嘅嚟講，咁個變量嘅影響咧就譬如話，如果你係講緊 initial cash outlay 嘅，即係負斯零，點解負數咧？因為佢一開始要俾錢嘛。咁如果你越大嘅話咧，就代表 NPV 咧基本上就可能會比較細一啲咯。我哋話佢同 NPV 嗰個嘅 negative 咧，係應該係一個 negative relationship 嚟嘅應該。咁之後，如果呢個越大咧，個 NPV 咧就越細啦。咁我諗咁細，或者即係呢個越大啦，個 NPV 咧就會越細啦。咁啊，第二個咧就係discount rate 啦 ，discount rate。咁即係我哋呢啲 I 呢啲字眼啦 ，discount rate。咁 discount rate 嚟講咧一樣啦，如果 discount rate 越高咧 ，OK，discount rate 越高，你個 NPV 咧就因為如果越高嘅話，即係 discount 令到上面嗰個數咧，令到上面呢堆數咧其實會細咗，咁所以變咗個 NPV 咧一樣啦，佢都係會越細嘅 ，OK， 得唔得？咁啊，再講啦，如果係個上面啲 C 咧，即係 C1、C2、CN， 咁點解去到 CN 咧？咁主要咧就係同翻嗰個去到幾多年有關 ，N 就代表個 project life 啦 ，OK。咁如果你越多 cash flow 嘅話咧，即係個收翻嚟嘅獲益咧就越高啦。咁所以咧，正常個 cash flow 越大咧，你個 NPV 咧就會越大嘅 ，OK 得唔得？咁因為我哋講係 net 嘅，咁 cash inflow 減去個 outflow 啦。咁然之後仲有咧就個 project life 啦 ，project life 嚟講咧就係嗰個 N 字啦，呢個 N 字就係個 project life 啦。 咁 project life 嚟講咧，正常嚟講，如果 project life 越長攤翻長啲嘅話咧，咁正常你每一個月即係正數嘅 net profit sorry net cash flow 翻嚟嘅話咧，咁應該咧你個 NPV 咧，其實咧應該就會係長啲嘅 ，OK sorry 會大一啲嘅，得唔得？咁當然都 depends 啦。如果你每個月都係 net outflow 嘅話咧，咁你基本上就好難回到本啦。咁甚至唔好講話帶嚟任何嘅 increase in value 啦。咁呢個就會係4.2 net present value 啦。好，咁睇一睇個 numerical examples。OK， 咁啊，我哋話咧呢度有個company C 啦。咁 company C 嚟講咧，你會見到咧佢話 implement a new project with 100,000 嘅 initial investment， 咁所以呢個就係個好明顯就係個 cash outflow 啦，咁所以負屋税。係啦，咁咧，然之後咧，咁我哋然之後咧，仲有再睇翻喎，每一年咧就 last for 3 years 啦，咁 expect to end an additional cash inflow， 咁佢就話咗俾你聽個 cash inflow 咧。就會係30,000 in year one 啦。咁然之後 year two 咧就40,000啦。year three 咧就會係65,000嘅。咁當然咧，你做嘅時候可以好似我咁咧，寫一條嘅timeline 嘅。咁就30,000 應該咁樣寫會好啲。我拆咗就寫個，咁我用唔同顏色，用綠色啦，綠色去標示翻。year one 三萬 ，year two 40,000，之後 year three 咧就65,000，係啦。咁然之後咧，佢話俾你聽咧，仲有一個好重要嘅信息咧，就是、residual value 4,000 at the end of year three。咁所以最尾嗰一年咧，記得加多4,000落去。OK， 咁所以咧，成條息嚟講，如果佢話俾你聽，做到最尾咧，我哋話嗰個有 10% 嘅 cost of goods sold 咧，咁最尾應唔應該做咧？咁我哋計一條，計翻寫翻條 equation。咁我哋話咧 ，NPV 就等於-100,000加30,000除1.1，點解點一咧？因為10% 嘛，再加多40,000。除1.1嘅2次，因為 discount 2次，咁我哋點睇嘅咧？咁咧，嗰個 discount 嘅方法咧就係咁，我哋處於第一年 ，OK， 新處於第一年，咁你咪數翻個 period 咯，呢度數翻點樣 count 啊？哦，數翻一格，咁 discount 1次啦，呢度兩格 discount， 咁所以其實咧，呢度我哋 implicit 咧有個一字喺度嘅，好啦，到最尾啦，做到最尾咧就係、是、加。65,000再加到4,000 over 1.1嘅3次 ，OK 嗱，記得呢度寫得我寫得好少少喎，呢度咧唔係1.12嚟嘅 ，OK 呢個係1.1嘅2次嚟 ，OK 咁得唔得？咁當然啦，最尾嗰個 discount 3次啦，你會見到咁又去翻呢度，咁所以到最尾計算咧，咁我為咗方便咧，佢之前已經計咗噶啦，咁應該等於1.13，咁呢個咧，我哋話咧，你見到咧個 NPV 咧，其實係一個 positive 嘅數，咁所以如果 NPV 係 positive 嘅話咧，咁所以你要答翻啦 ，NPV 就 is positive， 咁所以咧就應該 accept 個 project 啦。咁你話啊咩意思啊？即係話咧，當你一 implement 呢個 project 咧，就會帶嚟到會 bring 幾多？會 bring 到呢一個11,000 冰到 ring 到呢一個12,171.3嘅 increase in value 咧，超過 company。OK， 咁所以呢個就係嗰個 example 啦。好，咁到最尾咧 ，present value 第三部分啦。第三部分咧就講 comparison 啦，咁 advantage 同 disadvantage。咁我哋睇翻先，咁咧就NPV 嘅 advantage 咧，咁當然第一個就係 consider time value of money 啦。咁呢個咧都係會同翻我哋兩個去比較啦。第一個咧就 payback 啦。咁個 payback period 啦，又或者咧同翻呢一個 ARR 咧去比較，就會講 consider time value of money。咁頭先如果有睇前一段片嘅同學咧，都有見到點樣寫 time value of money 嘅解釋噶啦。咁呢個我唔多講啦。咁啊 ，time value of money 最緊要記得就係、是、啊，佢因為會 consider 咗個 discount cash flow 咁 from 嗰個 interest rate effect 啦。咁啊，第二啦，當然啊，亦都係同翻同上啦 ，consider 翻 payback period， 即係 VS payback period。係啦，咁呢個就純粹 VS 個 payback 啦。咁因為 payback 咧，我如果你有印象前一段片咧，都係話佢淨係 consider， 淨係 consider 呢一個payback 前面嗰啲 cash flow 嘅啫。咁但係 NPV 咧，我哋話會 consider 曬所有，咁比較一個 comprehensive 一啲啦 ，consider all cash flow in 個investment period 咁樣咯。咁啊，第三咧就 indicate 個 net worth of project。咁呢個通常咧，我哋就用嚟 VS 個 IRR 嘅。咁因為 IRR 嚟講咧，我哋話咧佢只係 indicate 到嗰個 rate 嘅啫。咁呢個 rate of return 啦。咁但係咧就話唔到俾你聽究竟個 project 個 net worth 即係 bring 到幾多 additional 嘅 value 咧俾你間公司嘅。咁所以我哋話咧。當你寫嘅時候就同 IRR 去比較啦。咁但係啦，有咩唔好處啊？唔好處咧就係話其實我哋通常咧，如果你做 project comparison 嘅時候咧，最好咧就揾翻一個 project 咧個 size 或者個 life 咧應該同差唔多先去比。咁但係 NPV 咧就唔得嘅。頭先都講過，如果 project life 越長嘅話咧，正常嘅 NPV 應該變出嚟係會越大嘅，因為經過 aggregate 嘅 effect 之後。咁所以咧，呢個。就幫唔到你去睇啦，因為 project with different life 嘅話咧，就 cannot be compare 啦。我哋話咁 different size 其實都唔係幾好嘅，即係最好兩個 compare 嘅時候咧，其實都最好都做翻 similar size 係比較好嘅。咁第二個咧就係 difficult to determine the suitable discount rate 啦。咁我哋話呢一個咧，其實咧就係、是、你要揾個 discount rate 其實都係難嘅。咁究竟點樣先做 discount rate 啫？咁當然你可以話用 expected rate of return 啦，用個 interest rate from the loan 啦，或者其他啲方法做 discount rate。咁但係點樣為之最適合咧？咁呢個都係有一個難度嘅。咁呢個就取決於間公司究竟想點樣做啦。因為如果你諗下個 discount rate 定得越低嘅話咧，其實咧變相你個 discount 出嚟嘅 cash flow 就越大，其實越容易達到你嗰想要嗰個目的嘅。OK， 咁所以就 depends on 究竟你間公司點樣去睇個 discount rate 啦。咁我呢個就係 advantage 或者 disadvantage 啦，咁希望大家咧都可以留心啦。